In the Brooklyn office of Dr. Fred Listwood, ambulatory foot surgery is performed in a modern, well-equipped office. Dr. Listwood, a 1966 graduate of the College of Podiatric Medicine, is a diplomate of the American Board of Ambulatory Foot Surgery. He is also a lecturer at the New York College of Podiatric Medicine. The office staff consists of a receptionist, a business secretary and typist, and two podiatric medical assistants. Office facilities include six totally equipped surgical medical suites. Ultraviolet sterilization lamps are on 24 hours a day and kill all airborne bacteria. Nitrous oxide and oxygen are pumped into each treatment room, and for convenience, there are six chairside X-ray units. Physical therapy equipment includes the electrogalvanic stimulator, Medco Duplet, and others such as the Jobst extremity pump and whirlpool. Preoperative screening includes blood chemistry and cell counts done in the office on the Accustat chemical analyzer and blood cell counter. Other pre-op tests include pulse volume recordings. Conservative treatment of fibrous neurolipoma, which works in a great many cases, is the Lawson-Lowe strapping technique. When the conservative treatment is unsuccessful, surgical correction is indicated. Before the scrub, the patient is premedicated with IM administration of 50 milligrams of Demerol, 25 milligrams Phenergan, and 1/150th of a grain of scopolamine. Local anesthesia consists of 6 cc's of a premixed solution of 2% lidocaine with epinephrine 1 to 100,000, prednisone acetate, and hyaluronidase. Dr. Listwood will now discuss the surgical removal of fibrous neurolipoma.
To familiarize ourselves with the anatomy of the area, the abductor digiti minimi, the flexor brevis digiti minimi, flexor brevis digitorum muscle, the flexor brevis hallucis muscle, the abductor hallucis muscle, the lateral plantar nerve, common digital branch of the medial plantar nerve, leading to the medial plantar nerve, the bifurcation of the medial plantar nerve, where the neurotripsy is performed when the surgery is done in the second interspace. The surgical procedure begins with an incision from the webs between the second and third toes, proximally. The skin is undermined with a mosquito hemostat. A Wheatlander retractor is put in to separate the tissues. A sharp dissection of the fibrous neurolipoma beginning at the distal aspect in the webs between the second and third toes and going proximally. The Wheatlander is reversed, separating the metatarsal heads, and an Allis clamp is put on the fibrous neurolipoma, which is introduced from the wound via sharp dissection. It is extremely important to deliver the entire mass. This is a nice sized fibrous neurolipoma, however, it is by no means the largest we have seen. We are searching for any neurofibrils that we might have not seen during the dissection. We have a clean interspace here, as you can see. We are now ready to do the neurotripsy. We take our number 15 blade and go between the metatarsal shafts until we reach the plantar aponeurosis, where the medial plantar nerve lies at its bifurcation. The patient will feel this and we will know we're in the right area. We then crush the nerve at its bifurcation with a large hemostat. There's approximately 5 to 10 seconds of pain during this procedure for the patient, but it's important that we know the location of the nerve, so that we do have to have the patient let us know at this time. That's why we do it under local anesthesia. As you can see, the spasm is completely broken, which is what we will see if the nerve is crushed properly. The wound is closed in layers. We use 2-0-Dexon deep. Skin is closed with 35 gauge stainless steel wire. I like to use wire for a variety of reasons, among which is the fact that it is the most non-reactive of all suture material. We can leave it in for the longest period of time if necessary. Also, there is a lot of tensile strength, obviously. A long subcuticular suture is used here. The disadvantage of working with wire is that it always requires two people at all times to avoid kinks, as you see the assistant is holding the wire out, preventing looping. There is always a space left in the web to allow for drainage so that we do not get hematoma formation. This space closes itself in approximately 2 weeks. Two simple sutures are used across the incision line to lock the subcuticular suture in place. The area is compressed to remove any excess blood through the opening in the web space. We have a nice even line. Adaptic is applied. A sterile compression bandage applied. An ACE bandage is applied over the entire dressing, and the patient is instructed to do a minimal amount of ambulation the first 3 days post-operatively. There is not a significant amount of post-operative discomfort, and the patients generally do very nicely on a post-operative course. The sutures are removed in approximately 2 weeks. Thank you.